Could this tweet really be worth millions of dollars when we've screenshot it for free? Madness? Maybe. But let us explain why it might not be quite as crazy as you think. This screenshot is actually a non-fungible token, better known as an NFT. NFTs have been around since 2014, though they really got popular in 2017 with the launch of blockchain-based virtual game CryptoKitties. Remember these? They became a symbol of the 2017 bull run as people paid huge amounts for collectible digital cats. Though most people weren't even really calling them NFTs back then. People mostly thought they were a bit of a joke. Now what the hell's an NFT? Apparently cryptocurrency. Everyone's making so much money. Well, they aren't laughing anymore.
Sotheby's, the top auction house, is going to be moving into the NFT space.
Things have really kicked off for the NFTs this year, reaching a pinnacle when digital artist Mike Winkelmann, known as Beeple, sold his 5,000 days piece for an astonishing $69 million. To understand why that value is even vaguely reasonable, let's break down exactly what they are. Put simply, an NFT is a digital token created on a blockchain. Anything digital can be copied infinitely, right? This was a key reason why early attempts to build digital money failed. Each NFT is a unique digital object that can't be replicated. They're used to prove exclusive ownership of a digital item, whether that's art, music, video games, or whatever. Think of NFTs as being to digital possessions what Bitcoin is to money. Bitcoin solved what's known as the double spend problem by using blockchain technology to ensure that each coin was unique and couldn't be reproduced. NFTs use blockchain technology for a similar purpose, to ensure exclusive ownership of an original digital item by storing and tracking it on the blockchain to provide buyers with proof of ownership. They also use smart contracts to facilitate the secure sale of the item. Essentially, NFTs offer a trustless and transparent way of proving a digital item's value, scarcity, and ownership. So, that's what it is. But the big question still probably is, why? NFTs have many benefits. For artists, NFTs offer a simple and innovative means to sell their work to a global audience. It's probably not a coincidence that they've taken off during the COVID pandemic, with lockdowns restricting physical events and leaving artists needing a new income stream. The barriers to entry are also pretty low for customers and artists. Anyone can do it because the technology is secure and simple to use. You don't need to be in a specific place or use a currency associated with a country to get in on the action. For the buyer, only one person actually owns the original version. It's an easy way to support your favorite artist and to claim the blockchain-based bragging rights of ownership. So, the million-dollar question. Do NFTs actually have value?
This really has the potential to bypass a lot of the traditional gatekeepers and vetting processes.
Value is a tricky concept at the best of times, and it's all relative. There are people out there who'll pay $11,000 for a pair of Nike Yeezys. Does it make sense to spend more on a pair of shoes than you would on a new car? It doesn't really come down to the object itself. It's all about the market and what people are willing to pay. And why should NFTs have more or less value than physical paintings, which can also be copied or reprinted? You could Google a picture of Van Gogh's Starry Night tomorrow, print it, and hang it on your wall. The thing is, it wouldn't be the real deal, because it isn't the original, which is worth a fortune. Even though you can make your own copy of a digital item, you don't necessarily own it outright. And being that person will always have value. Where there's demand and hype, buyers and collectors will inevitably lap it up. Whether or not this is a passing fad or a lasting revenue stream for artists is a more complicated question. What's for sure is that the world is going digital, so it makes a lot of sense. What's your take on NFTs? Would you pay $1 million for a screenshot of a tweet? Let us know in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and give this video a big thumbs up.